I would talk about assessment of recovery of tenor atrophy in carpal tunnel syndrome by ultrasonography. The atrophy of tenor muscles is observed with the progression of CTS.
It is important to evaluate by ultrasonography
objectively. How do we evaluate objectively?
I would talk about assessment of recovery of tenor atrophy gaining importance in carpal tunnel evaluating by ultrasonography
of the hand. Its advantages are first, non-invasive.
I would talk about assessment
second,
of recovery of tenor
real-time imaging
in carpal tunnel
third,
syndrome
low
by ultrasonography.
The aim
of
this study is to assess
recovery
the objective analysis
in
of tenor atrophy
syndrome by
ultrasonography
in patients with CTS. 36 patients,
I would talk about
10 males and 26 females were included
in carpal tunnel syndrome by ultrasonography.
The mean age was 67.8 years old.
I would
Step
talk
one,
about assessment of recovery
patients
of tenor atrophy
were classified according
in carpal tunnel
to the physiological
severity
scale.
We evaluated abductor pollicis brevis and opponent pollicis muscles
about assessment
by
of recovery
ultrasonography
atrophy
in carpal tunnel syndrome by ultrasonography.
The transitional change of APB and OPP depths were analyzed by
I
the ratio.
I talk about assessment of recovery of tenor atrophy in carpal tunnel syndrome by ultrasonography.
A nerve conduction test was performed and classified according to the
I would talk about assessment of recovery of
electrophysiological severity
in
scale
in carpal tunnel
stage 1 to 5
by ultrasonography.
Preoperative electrophysiological assessment was classified.
I would talk about
stage
assessment
three,
of recovery of
males
atrophy
and 3 females
in carpal tunnel syndrome
stage 4
by ultrasonography.
4 males and 14 females.
Stage 5 2 males and
I would
11
talk
females
about assessment of recovery
of
tenor atrophy
Kanatani's
in carpal tunnel
syndrome by ultrasonography.
Ultrasonographic evaluation was performed
assessment
to evaluate
recovery of tenor atrophy
the in carpal tunnel syndrome by ultrasonography.
So the transducer was applied onto the palmar surface of the
I
hand.
I will talk about assessment of recovery of
longitudinal axis
in carpal tunnel syndrome
by ultrasonography.
Both muscles were analyzed by measuring their thickness.
I would talk
the
about
APB
assessment
depth
of recovery
from
of tenor atrophy
prominence
in carpal tunnel syndrome
OPP
by ultrasonography.
Muscle about the first metacarpal bone to the palmar surface.
I would talk about assessment of recovery
OPP
of tenor atrophy
from the ulnar tunnel syndrome
of the first metacarpal
sonography
to the palmar surface of the OPB.
I would talk about
this
assessment
is an
of recovery of tenor
evaluation
in carpal
tunnel
syndrome by ultrasonography.
We examined APB depths and OPP depths.
I would talk about assessment of recovery of tenor atrophy in carpal tunnel syndrome by ultrasonography.
This is a representative case.
The image is 47 years old female.
I will talk about assessment
CTS
of recovery of tenor atrophy in carpal tunnel syndrome by ultrasonography.
6.2 mm
and the OPP depth was 4.4 mm.
I will talk about assessment
the
of recovery
APB depth
of tenor atrophy
7.8
in carpal tunnel syndrome by
and the
ultrasonography.
OPP depth was 4.9 mm. After 1 year operation,
I would talk about assessment of recovery of tenor atrophy in carpal tunnel syndrome.
The image by is
71 years old female, right CTS, stage 5.
The
APB depth
was 2.5
mm
of atrophy
and the OPP
in carpal
depth
tunnel
was
syndrome
2.6
mm
preoperatively.
The APB depth was 8.7 mm.
I would talk about assessment
and
of recovery
OPP depth
of tenor atrophy
3
in carpal tunnel syndrome by ultrasonography.
After 1 year operation,
I would talk about
this
assessment
is the results
of recovery
of
atrophy
transitional change ratio
by ultrasonography.
The increase of the ratio in stage 4 and 5 demonstrated the recovery
I would
of
talk
APB
about assessment
and OPP
of recovery
atrophy
of atrophy
at 1 year post syndrome
by ultrasonography.
The tenor atrophy is shown in advanced CTS.
I would talk
we
about assessment
of recovery
of tenor
evaluation
atrophy
method
in carpal
tunnel
muscle
atrophy
by ultrasonography.
We evaluated the recovery
of the tenor
atrophy by using
tenor
ultrasonography
in carpal tunnel syndrome
by
the increase
of the
ratio in stage 4 and 5 demonstrated the recovery of both
I would talk
APB
about assessment
of recovery
of
tenor atrophy
at 1 year
in carpal tunnel syndrome by ultrasonography. In conclusion, our autosomal evaluation of Turner atrophy of recovery in CTS atrophy
could be a useful carpal tunnel syndrome
for evaluating the post-operative recovery of Turner atrophy.
Thank you for your kind
attention.
I will
talk about assessment of recovery of Turner atrophy in carpal tunnel syndrome by ultrasonography.